god awful indeed. So, yeah. All right, from Spiritbreaker's perspective, what level is like prime time?
Oh,
top
Peter's
lane,
dead.
GPD,
I think.
Snowballed up into a split earth. Great call, Syndra, in a 3v1, and you called that the one died. Jayo, in the meantime, attempting to run away. He's going to take a little harassment damage. A nice triple decay, though. Very
this
juicy
is,
indeed.
This is pretty clever laning from Freedom. I think they've set themselves up to potentially win three lanes. This top lane does get tricky soon, though, but if they get another kill now...
Jesse again, a huge decay, though. Another triple, I believe. Oh. 32 strength steal for Jayo. He's the carry now.
Undying has 22 plus 37 strength. The new silencer Axe is really not that good, I think. I said that about the Gyrax last game. He's probably buying it first time.
I mean, it's not one of the best. That's certainly true.
I think you go... Generally, Pyke is really good. Pyke and Treads. You could get a Midas as a mid-silencer. I think that's really good. The hero scales very well with the attack speed. And of course,
Tusk.
Getting levels.
Oh, Tusk is getting beat on
by Jayo. Like he's
Jayo.
Just fine.
Oh, nice Ice Shard.
Decent Shards. Oh, that's not going to end well at all, actually.
Yeah, the cast plus decay is enough to help get the kill on Tusk. BSJ is pretty fast thanks to the overwhelming odds. And is likely to get away just fine. Eagle, in the meantime, getting... Locked
he
off
has
here
killed
by
Dragon
DK.
Tail
yeah, Dragon Tail plus a DD if he really needs it. No Roche Deny for you. But bottom line, this is more interesting than anything, because Boris, probably.
It's one of the int cores that actually is pretty good with Atos. I could see him buying that.
Yeah, that's true. Atos is pretty core, actually.
Great stats for that hero. Obviously, good to root heroes in place when you don't really have a good stun or slow as a core. Oh, that's very ambitious from Eagle here.
Leshrac was stunned up, double dual breath, and looks like Leshrac is going to be the hero of choice for Boris and company. They take him out with ease. Loki, in the meantime, Ice Shard's going to make a little bit more inconvenience walk for PPD, but the right clicks continue, and Tusk, down he goes to the Breathe Fire.
The Wanted are doing a good job at finding these kills, but they're more or less neck and neck, so it's about whether they transition these kills into objectives later or get
bottom
their key
lane.
Items.
Nether Strike into a charge, into a lucky bash for Boris. One more right click will do it. Down goes the Batrider. But who does that favor in the end? Because you're right, Team Freedom is out farming one.
In my opinion, at least, not favored. Duo is a really good player, so if he's losing like this to Tomato, then there is something to say about the matchup as well, right? Like, unless he's just getting brutally outplayed.
Well,
generally
he's getting initiated
dying.
On with four yeah, heroes and... Yeah, that's gonna hurt. Triple decay for Jayo yet again, but the tombstone's gonna be free farm.
You level it up at least 2 or 3 points.
Wanted's gonna group up bottom and take out this tier one. In the meantime, Chessy top lane is dusted up and dueled up, and that is the first duel damage going to BSJ on the Legion Commander. Of course, that is a trade for a tier one, but something I'm really interested in is Chessy may run into the majority of Team Freedom here. Close to the Ancients. They're going to attempt to go on Boris.
Oh.
The split earth misses completely, and the right clicks are enough to take out Eagle. Chessy takes one for himself. Going to get snowballed up, but the Ice Shards actually do not help him. Favors wanted in that effect. So 2 for nothing right now. Boris will be okay for now. As actually, they take out Silencer as well by the Tier 1 mid. And this could transition to at least some damage to the Tier 1s. They're going to continue to dive. BSJ charged up, stunned up. Gonna be okay for now. Might need to go shrine up with the help of Batrider.
Oh, if Eagle gets a good stun here, he definitely doesn't.
Split Earth completely misses, and now Leshrac's the one in trouble. His QO. He did have haste, but it's already been ended. Snowball. I'm actually surprised they're going in with such low HP. IX Mike goes into his death. Now BSJ next on the list, but Boris cancels the charge.
Right. This Witch Doctor healer was the MVP of that fight, that's for sure.
Might have to be the sacrificial lamb of sorts, or wanted.
Ooh,
actually get a duel
nice
out of it.
Damage. Crazy fight. Very important for wanted that they kill the silencer early on. In that fighting into this Team Freedom line, it was really difficult. Oh, there's a charge.
Yeah, IX Mike and company wanted to get the Dragon Knight, but they'll just find
Boris
a Spirit Breaker
in
to
a lot of trouble here.
Himself.
He's pretty dead.
I think. I mean, that was essentially kill either Dragon Knight or SB, and SB's like, just take me, please. But as far as talents go, the hero I wanted.
The problem with a hero like Undying is generally on your first life you've used your tombstone and your ulti, and those are your big spells. So if you come back to life faster, your second life isn't actually that impactful. Oh, nice play here from Ike's. Mike actually gonna stay alive with last TP. Very well done. So yeah, I definitely think GPM. And it's also, if you're playing support, you know, GPM talents are just a Heaven Sent, right? It's your ticket to scaling.
See, our first global silence of the game is Undying is going to be the first to drop in this engagement. So one for one, though, with the Letrek. Duel onto Dragon Knight. BSJ actually wins that. He might cost him his life with the Maledict slash Death Ward combination of Witch Doctor. And Silencer used his ult, taking right clicks on another bash for Boris. Doesn't have another charge for another 5 seconds, but the Cask doing a nice job of bouncing left and right. Looks like Loki's going to live through the day, though. And IX Mike, of course, no lasso, as you said, already used it to get away. He's going to get charged up, but...
Oh, he's baiting like them pretty well here. Yeah, that's a kill again on Boris.
Snowball, no Split Earth, but probably enough to take him out regardless.
You know what sucks playing Spirit Breaker?
Everything.
Stinky Nape.
Just agree with me. Just say I'm right.
Yeah,
there's
you're
no
right,
need to have
Kappa.
A conversation, though. Thank you. I'll take that regardless of the Kappa. Smoke up here by PPD and company as they're going to converge onto Silencer. He does have Global Silence in 10 seconds, but can he live through the day? A nice initiation here. Peter Pan Dam, my god. That is a long duration Death Ward. They're going to find two kills pretty much right off the bat as Loki is going to have to fall back. J.O., you okay, buddy? All right. Pretty low. Diabolic Edict was owning him. And the
what
tier one tower
the
looks
fuck is that face of Undying? It looks like Nyx.
That's the, yeah, that's true. That's the new set, bro. Oh, nice snowball is going to avoid the Cask. Looks like they find a kill on Silencer in the back end, though, and Loki looks to be next on the list. Wanted. Just spiraling out of control here.
That was all over the place. I think the key point there is that...
Just in time for Spirit
Breakers.
Yeah,
I think Klinks will.
Yeah, Chessie, like, you got no mana. You're not hitting your Split Arts anyway, so should be able to take this kill. Walrus Punch is going to keep Chessie in place, but of course, Vision...
What the fuck, Map
thanks
Hack?
To Spirit Breaker. Yes, a.k.a. Map Hack. For sure.
Well, at least it doesn't draw the entire Vision blue anymore. Oh.
Oh yeah, Undying with that vagina face is going to put down the tombstone. Here we have the fight. IX Mike taking the right click from Chessie as a snowball comes into place with BSJ attempting to TP out. Might be fine thanks to the global silence. Loki, not going to be lucky. 24 seconds left on that cooldown, so down he goes.
That's another global used, and they don't win the fight. This is looking really, really... I wouldn't mind. I think Silver Edge is a great item when you already have
I Shadow. Agree. Tomato, Nether Striked up into a Dragon Tail. He doesn't even have mana for his ult, even if he wanted to use it.
Nice
down
KS charge there from Boris.
That's how you do it in pubs. He's learned from the best.
You just pretend.
Pop his ult, going for IX Mike, a nice break
which hero
of the
were
stun.
You
Klinks.
Yeah, that's definitely not a farming hero. You want to fight early with your
oh, some auto-initiated on again. No global silence for you. It's a one-for-one. He buys back. And the Death Ward again. PPD is doing work with these casks. Maledicts. I'm just going to list all his spells. Voodoo Restoration. All right, Kyo did have Silver Edge. He still does on... he has it queued up, but... He's like, you know what? I'm going to go for some more mobility. How about a Blink Dagger on top of my Shadow Blade, that sounds good. Chessie in the meantime, looking for an LC kill. Not gonna find it thanks to the Ice Shards as Boris was looking to assist. But DK form, this should be a very dead tier 2 tower. Tomato might be getting stuck out again, and he does not have buyback, and they know this. 60 seconds on the deck. Don't see any reason for Wanted to back up now.
This is...
Oh,
okay,
boy.
BSJ joins his friend.
All right, the chain feed has begun, ladies and gentlemen.
You're not going down in a bad position alone, buddy. I'll make you look.
Fight this. I think they take the tower and back. They're happy with these.
We'll see. I feel like they're strong enough to just brute force this Rex as well. We'll see, though.
But why would you take the chance? Undying is going to be perhaps the sacrificial lamb. They're not
you're
able
right.
to get the Rex in
they
time.
They didn't actually get it. It was close, though.
BSJ,
oh, good duel.
He wants the duel onto DK. Global Silence is going to keep him in place. Nobody can use any spells.
Oh,
that's what that skill
that.
Does. Which, how many duel wins is that? I wish it would actually say. Just says that.
Could probably kill Tomato. Oh, Tomato has Ghost Sentinel. He's going to see that
Tomato.
Now. I'm going to go for the September, I think.
Does Chessie pick up
oh,
a defusal
maybe with a charge.
To counter this?
Ghost Scepter? Use your Ghost Scepter.
What? Right. What? I don't understand what we just watched. That was conceding without actually conceding.
It's possible the hotkey for that fell off his keyboard, and then he's just trying to find the Ghost Scepter key fast.
But then,
so he's like,
okay, so
takes
how do
his
you
hands
explain
off
him?
The keyboard, tries to grab that button, and put it back on.
Uh-oh. Dragon Knight brought in by the lasso. He's going to get stunned up. He's taking a lot of damage, actually. Armlet toggling to the best of his ability. He won't live through the day, but they will find two kills, and all they really need is Chessie to take out these barracks.
Yep. That's two lanes.
Oh, BSJ. Nether struck up. And dropped to the deck yet again. Buyback on Dragon. I just want to finish this. Like, fuck this shit.
Interestingly for me, it seems like Wanted are more comfortable on their heroes in this game than the first one. And the reason that's strange is that, you know, it's elimination mode, so you should get less and less comfortable per
game. Right.
But this draft just seems so... Yeah, they're just... They're grouping up as a team, they know exactly what they need to do, their lineup is coming together nicely. They have some of their trademark heroes, like the Undying for Jo, the Witch Doctor for PPD, obviously also very good. Chessie plays a great Klinx. So they got a nice draft this game, they executed very well, and Team Freedom, they need to step it up a bit. I feel like this game they definitely had a good fighting chance, but their execution just wasn't really there in the team fights. They just got outplayed.
This looks to be the final engagement, perhaps, as Silencer is still dead for another 40 seconds. Tusk dies, buys back, IX Mike. One more right click. Oh, it's not enough, actually. About 60 HP to boot. Jesse and company gonna group up on LC. Don't think you want to get a duel out of this. And again, kill after kill, dropping like flies is Team Freedom. They will find the Spearbreaker, perhaps, though. Klinks, in the meantime, lassoed up. No damage to speak of, so we're just watching.
They got the tombstone.
We're just watching people fight. Dead. Dead. By the way, how much more enjoyable is Tusk for you with this?
Most games.
And Rubick was left untouched, by the way, in all three games, both ban
yeah,
and.
That is very surprising.
I mean, we've seen that in Captain's Mode, picked first overall in some cases.
Aw, mid lane BSJ. It's a good decrepify off. He's still dead, I think. This is
gonna hurt. QO with a DD. He's going to do a lot of damage. Eagle, though, with a nice fissure. Not going to save his comrade. QO. Actually going to get a free ward out of this. Nope. Denied. Get wrecked.
Yeah.
For Wanted. Been really impressed.
Yeah, he's been showing good games for sure. Holy shit, this Phoenix is getting owned. Oh.
Phoenix bottom.
Close call. Boris is also taking a lot of damage.
In the top lane, Jakiro is under attack. Gets ganked by Jo and Chessie. Ends up, yeah.
Your other heroes can push towers. I would say something like Vanguard into Hood. And then maybe, I guess,
Eagle.
Pipe or Crimson.
Mid
or
lane.
Both.
Getting quite low. The X marks the spot. Holds him in place for so long along with the Torrent. And again, pretty easy kill for the way of Wanted.
Well, QO is coming bottom. There's the Chrono.
Gets the Chrono off. Boat will connect. And with the help of Phoenix, Sunray. Ends up
he has another X. No
yeah,
torrent for this one.
It's one of the most ridiculous spells in the game.
That was very popular with Armlet into. Was it? He generally went after Armlet. Sometimes actually Armlet into Daedalus straight, I think, as a, like a semi carry 4 style. Yeah, talking about the important things here. Oh man, don't mind that kill top.
It was a 3v1. I was watching it, don't worry. Although I'm not camera, so maybe it does matter. Either way though, BSJ X'd up mid. Oh! I thought he was X'd up. Never mind. It was just a boat. Not hitting anything, but he'll be able to drink that rum nice and juicy, tank up these creeps, very important.
Dyer's
but
top tower
either way, it looks like BSJ is heading towards top as he sees Chessie and company looking to at least do some damage to this tower. Ogre Magi, though.
Good fissure.
Wrong place, wrong time. Gets stunned up. He's going to be hard-pressed to get out of here. I don't see how it's possible. It's not possible.
Dyer's middle tower is under
he
attack.
Is killed. So 5-1 advantage for Wanted.
Lead. It's not very accurate. But at the same time, the main narrative in the games is about kills, right? That's what gets talked about the most. So you can follow what the narrative has been. Of course, like sometimes the team with 10 kills is behind the team that has one kill if they have better late game. But then, yeah, I could see. I think a mix of both would be good. I think it would be a shame if you removed kills from there.
Respect but, died yeah. while you were talking. Anytime
we've got really good timing
dies.
On this. Who cares about the playback? This is especially sick with the subset of heroes. Like Tinker comes to mind.
Yeah.
Pretty crazy with X. Some cool plays you can do with that. Maybe something like Furion as well with 2 TPs could be cool. Mid lane. IX Mike. They have a Chrono.
Yeah, they do.
I think they're
going to
blow
it
here. Maybe not. Nope.
No,
they don't
need
it. They're all there.
It's going to be a kill for Bristleback, although he's doing a lot of damage to the cool sprays.
Sorry for the dry coughing, I've got a little bit of that going on. Right, heroes on Radiant have their ultimates. There was definitely a timing window before that where they could have threatened some towers.
This Bristleback, not feeling super tanky against this lineup of Wanted. Oh, there's a Chronosphere on two. Boat is going to connect. That is a bye-bye Pugna. Keeper of the Light in the meantime. Going to get a nice blinding light. Boris trying to right-click, but of course having that mischance. X into Egg. They can't attack it. It's only a level 1 Egg. But it's not going to matter.
Bristleback
is going down one way or the other. And a Black Hole, in fact, used onto Earthshaker. He gets a nice fissure. Does he have his ult? No, he's only level 5, so that's going to be another kill going the way of Wanted. 10 to 1 of their advantage, 2,400 gold. In meanwhile, top lane, Tomato.
I don't know how good that is, to be honest. I feel like it doesn't really... Drum was nerfed a while back and hasn't really been the same item ever since. It's on a hero like Kunkka, you don't really need the mana when you have both bottle and wand. And the attack speed isn't that great for that hero. It's more about the one cleave you see right there, doing a lot of damage. So.
Team Freedom's gonna get the tier
very
1
nice
tower
fissure.
Fissure. Very nice. Not quite blocking off completely, but Jayo looks to be dead regardless. And QO trying to get through. Finally, the fissure's gone. He's gonna have to use his boat for the buff. And a nice Echo Slam by Eagle onto two. The aggression continues, and Keel can barely move with all these move speed slows. Team Freedom getting a nice couple kills along with the tower, and they've almost evened up this game. Just with actually, as I say that.
Yeah, well, this. Push is surely being delayed. Oh, this is very aggressive from PPD going in like this.
Oh, he
gets into the ice panel.
He does have Egg to get out of dodge here. Faceless Void gets a Chrono onto two. Sunray is going to do a lot of damage. Here's the Torrent into Boat. BSJ is going to be the first casualty. A nice Black Hole on two, and that's three dead to start off the fight. Bristleback trying to go for Phoenix, but the Egg comes out, stuns him, and down goes Bristleback as well. So that fight took so long to actually finally begin, and when it does, Wanted just everything up except for Black Hole, which is probably still enough, and Enigma has the completed BKB, which they're probably going to spot right about now. Nice ice path onto two, and here comes the Chronosphere. It's going to be onto with the Sunray combination. Down goes Pugna. Boat connects on Jakiro. In fact, Pugna is going to buy back. We'll see how this works out as the Bash is going to connect onto Earthshaker. He is completely stunlocked thanks to Ogre Magi. Tomato gets off a decent ice path, but it's not enough to save his life. And
that's
Pugna
an
buyback ends
guy.
Up being completely
Oh, he didn't
wasted.
Get it off? Nope, he didn't get him. Oh, he did? Wow, I didn't hear the sound. Okay. Interesting. Oh, last second catch there. Oh, the fissure fails.
Yeah, Kyo is able to heal up a bit thanks to the armlet completely toggled away. Pandam. Pandam PPD. Echo slammed up. In fact, his Icarus dive is going to be canceled. Is he going to live through this? No, but last right click is going to finish him off. So, Team Freedom does get one. Do they train here? Chessy and QO wrap around from the other side as BSJ tries to run away, probably to no avail. He's going to get X'd up into a torrent. And away he goes to the grave as it looks like Earthshaker also drops to the deck. Jayo is going to be the sacrificial lamb for Wanted. Yules onto Chessy. Still has the 9-second BKB to use if he wishes. Boris! Double Chronosphere. They have a Black Hole if they want. And they're actually going to use it. Easy kills going the way of Wanted yet again. Tomato tries to use his spells to full effect, but it's going to be to no avail. He's the last remaining member of Freedom. And I would not be shocked with a GG here. But
I think you still play for this. Now all the cooldowns are used. Now you try one last push down mid and see if you can...
Perhaps.
Get that or get the Roche.
Oh,
it wasn't
boy.
Claimed. Doesn't help that Shaker gets killed here, of course. Just gonna slow them down a bit further. But actually, nah, he's respawns at about the same time. Just bought a damage alternative. I think it's fine.
We have a potential.
Here we go.
Last ditch effort.
Last
from
hurrah
Freedom.
Here. This is a
they
Hail Mary.
The,
I know you like
that pipe?
Reference because it sounds like NFL.
That's great. Thank you. Thank
yeah,
you for catering to our
PPD
American audience. Oh, PPD doesn't have Egg for another 2 seconds. He's going to get Yulzed up. Doesn't have mana to use right now. Echo Slam's going to be used on, I believe, one hero, and he's just going to backtrack most of the damage. Jayo, nice use of the Shrine. Going to force IX Mike into a terrible position. Has almost no mana. This Defusal Blade is doing absolute work. It's a 1-for-1. A core Jakiro for a support Phoenix. And the fight
this
will continue.
Kyo
jumps in.
Mech Kyo is more than fine here.
Yeah, this is... I don't know how you fight this if you're Freedom. No, they can try for the high ground game now. They have Keeper of the Light after all, and Jakiro. but what are they delaying for?
Exactly, know? That's the problem. They have weaker late game. Like the fresh orb, you can't really get out of position in any way. Even at one core, getting out of position can just get chrono and kill.
Tomato gets off some nice spells. Boris is just sitting here in Viz. Gets a chrono onto two. Didn't even see the second hero, but Earthshaker's gonna pop like nothing. Keeper of the Light's gonna be next on the list. Bristol back. You are not tanky against all this farm from Boris. And GG's are gonna come out, so Wanted will move on to the next stage of the tournament, which they'll face up against the loser of Complexity.